In this video, we're continuing on with the area of regular polygons worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Picking up where we left off with number 11, our directions are to use what you know about special right triangles to find the area of each regular polygon. Leave your answer in simplest form. Now there are two special right triangles that we know. We know the 30, 60, 90 triangle, where the ratios are 1, square root of 3, and 2 for the sides. We also know the 45, 45, 90 triangle, where the ratios are 1, 1, and the square root of 2 for the sides. Now in number 11, we have a regular triangle. So here is our right triangle. And remember that in a regular triangle, one interior angle is 60 degrees. So if we were to bisect that angle of 60 degrees, this angle here would be 30 degrees, making this angle 60 degrees. So we have a 30, 60, 90 triangle. Now we're given that 18 is this length here, but we want to solve for the area. And the area, remember, is 1/2 of the apothem times the perimeter. So putting in our ratios, across from 30 is 1, opposite 60 is the square root of 3, and 2 is represented by 18. 1, square root of 3, 2. 30, 60, 90. So what we can do is set up ratios to solve. Let's start out by solving for the apothem. And this, for the sake of convenience, let's call the apothem little a, since area is represented by big A, and let's call the other side of this triangle B. So using a ratio, 2 is to 18, as 1 is to our apothem A. Cross multiplying, we'll get that 2A equals 18. And when we divide by 2, we'll get that A is equal to 9. So we know that this length of the apothem is 9. Now, let's solve for B. 2 is to 18 as the square root of 3 is to B. Cross multiplying, we'll get 2B equals 18 times the square root of 3. And when we divide by 2, we'll get that B is equal to 9 times the square root of 3. Now remember, area is 1/2 of the apothem times the perimeter. And the side of this triangle, B, is 1/2 the length of this side of our larger polygon. So if we were to take 2B, 2B is the length of one side. And we solved for B, so the area A equals 1/2 of the apothem, which is from the center to the midpoint of a side, which we got is 9, times the perimeter, which we know the perimeter is the number of sides in, times the length of a side. So for a triangle, our perimeter is going to be 3 times the length of that side, which is 2b, and b we know is 9 times the square root of 3. So the area equals 1/2 of 9 times 3 times 2 is 6. 6 times 9 is 54. So 54 square root of 3 is the perimeter. So the area equals 1/2 times 9 times 54 times the square root of 3, which will give us 243 times the square root of 3 units squared as the area in number 11. In number 12, we have a hexagon, and they give us the apothem A as 4 times the square root of 3. This triangle, again, if you remember, that one angle within a hexagon is 120 degrees. So when we cut that angle in 1/2, we get 60 degrees. So again, we have a 60, 30, 90 triangle. So our ratios, across from 30 is 1, across from 60 is the square root of 3, and opposite 90 is 2. Those are our ratios for the sides. So if A is 4 times the square root of 3, 4 times the square root of 3 is to the square root of 3, the side we're looking for, let's call the side B, is to 1. Cross multiplying, we'll get 4 times the square root of 3 equals the square root of 3 times B. And when we divide by the square root of 3, we'll get that 4 is equal to B. So this distance is 4. And remember, the perimeter is the number of sides on the figure, which is 6 in this case, times the length of one side, which since this is the midpoint, the length of this total side is 4 times 2. And we know that 4 times 2 is 8. So the perimeter is 6 times 8, which is 48. So now we're going to plug each of those numbers in for our area formula. Area equals 1 half the apothem, which is 4 times the square root of 3, times our perimeter of 48. So area equals 1 half times 4 times 48 times the square root of 3, which is 96 times the square root of 3. So 96 times the square root of 3 units squared is our area and number 12. Moving on to 13, we have a triangle. They give us the length of one of the sides, so our perimeter P is going to be equal to 3 times the length of that side, 10, so the perimeter is equal to 30, since a triangle has 3 sides and 10 is the length of one side. So now we just need to calculate for the apothem to solve. If we know that one side is 10, half of 10 is 5, so the length of one leg of the triangle will be 5, since 5 times 2 is equal to 10. So this is our 90 degrees, this is our 60 degrees, and this is our 30 degrees. Across from 30 is 1, across from 60 is the square root of 3, and across from 90 is 2. So let's set up a ratio to solve for our apothem A. We know that this side is 5, so 5 is to the square root of 3, as our apothem A is to the number 1. Cross multiplying, 5 times 1 is 5, and that's equal to the square root of 3 times A, which is A square root of 3. Dividing by the square root of 3, we get 5 divided by the square root of 3 is equal to A. And I do not want the square root of 3 on the bottom, so I'm going to simply multiply by 1, which will not change the value. So I'm going to multiply by the square root of 3 over the square root of 3. So that'll be 5 times the square root of 3 all over square root of 3 times square root of 3 is 3. 5 thirds times the square root of 3, or 5 times the square root of 3 over 3 equals our apothem A. Entering all those numbers into our area formula, we'll have 1 half our apothem, which we got as 5 square root of 3 over 3, and that gets multiplied to our perimeter of 30. And one easy thing to do is simplify. So 3 goes into 30 10 times. So as opposed to writing 1 half times 5 times the square root of 3 over 3 times 30, we're going to write 1 half times 5 times the square root of 3 times 10, because you can see that 3 goes into 30 10 times. So I just divided 30 by 3 at the start. So 1 half times 5 times 10 is going to equal 25, because 5 times 10 is 50, divided by 2 is 25, and we're multiplying that by the square root of 3. So our area equals 25 times the square root of 3. And number 14, it gives us that our side is 8. And this is a hexagon, so I know that this angle is going to be 60, and this angle is going to be 30, and this, of course, is 90. Setting up my ratios, across from 90 degrees is 2, across from 60 is the square root of 3, and across from 30 is 1. So we have 2 is to 8, as the square root of 3 is to A. So when I cross multiply, I'll get that 2a equals 8 times the square root of 3. Dividing both sides by 2, I'll get that a is equal to 4 times the square root of 3. So a is 4 square root of 3. Now I'm going to solve for this side, which we've been calling b. So 2 is to 8, as 1 is to b. Cross multiplying, I'll get 2b equals 8, and when I divide by 2, I'll get that b is equal to 4. And remember, for my perimeter p, this is a hexagon, so we have 6 sides, and one side is equal to 2 times b. So perimeter equals 6 times 2b, and that equals 6 times 2 times 4. 6 times 2 times 4 is 48. So area equals 1 half of our apothem, which is 4 times the square root of 3, and then we're multiplying that by the perimeter of 48. So A equals 1 half of 4 is 2, 2 times 48 is 96, and we're multiplying 96 by the square root of 3. So 96 times the square root of 3 is my solution in number 14. And I'll go ahead and stop this video here. In the next video, we'll finish out this worksheet doing numbers 15 through 18. However, remember your special triangles. 30, 60, 90, 45, 45, 90 gives you ratios that you can use to solve for the sides.